Hi, my name's Daniel Robinson and I'm a software developer for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate the new feature of auto-completing ibmint commands when using a bash shell. This feature is a personal favorite of mine as it enables bash auto-completion when building the ibmint commands on the command line. If you're not familiar, autocompletion uses the tab key to offer suggestions of available command options and possibly values based on the context of the command line at the time. As it's bash, unfortunately, the feature is not available on the Windows systems, but it is available on all the Linux and Unix-based systems, including Mac, as long as you're running a bash shell. The feature has been available since 13.0.2. And it should be automatically enabled when you run the MQSI profile script, which is necessary in order to use any of the commands with the product. It can also be manually enabled by sourcing the ibmint complete script, which is found in the ACE installation directory under /bash autocompletion. As the ibmint commands are quite complex by the nature of how you build the command up from multiple words, in addition, they also have only long name flags, so there's a lot more typing that's needed, and so a lot more room for error or mistakes, and sometimes not knowing what the right flags to use are can be a problem. For example, when running the ibmint set credential command, in order to know what credential types and what auth types might be available, you may need to run additional commands and cross-reference the output. So the aim of this piece of work was to make things easier for people in order to discover what flags were available and appropriate for the command they were running, potentially based on some of the flags that they had already set. This should be more clear in a minute when I actually run through some of the examples. So let's start off by sourcing the MQSI profile from my 13.0.2 ACE installation. So now I can use the tab key to show me a list of commands available. If I start off by just showing help, you can see here how all the verb words that can precede ibmint are shown above. I've just run the help so you can cross-reference and see the complete set is indeed being shown to you. So the first thing I was going to do would be to show how you can get some help with the nodes. So let's create some nodes. Let's call it demo node. And if I now run the MQSI list command, we can see I have a demo node down the bottom. If I wanted to start the node, see ST is matching start or stop. So I'll add the A and then I can get start, put the node in. And now it's offering a bunch of nodes. So maybe I want to start the demo node. And conversely, I can stop the demo node. If I wanted to delete the node, I would also get the things offered there for me. However, if I run a create command, I do not get it, as you might have seen above, because it doesn't make sense to offer existing node names when you're creating a new node. But it might make sense to create a server and attach it to an existing node, which is why you get the node suggestions available to the integration node flag, as you can see here. Okay, so let's start the demo node so I can actually create the servers. So if I go back, just show you, see, so if I tab on integration node, it shows me all of them. Because I put the DE, it would only match demo node, so it's auto-filled the rest in for me. And the same is true if I wanted to start a server. If I start by giving it the node first, and then it will be able to help me by offering servers attached to that node. So you can see here, I've actually got demo server 1 and demo server 2. So I could choose to start number 2, for example. I could also choose to delete a server. So you could put the server name straight in after the server keyword in the command. But if we give it the integration node first, it can now offer me a selection of servers to do. So let's delete the first one. And finally, just for completeness, let's stop the node. So that was a quick overview of how you can create, start, stop, and delete nodes and servers with some assistance from the auto-completion feature that will show you the names of available nodes and servers on your machine to help you target the right things and avoid so much typing and making mistakes. We also have some commands that let you set values. So let's, for example, on the admin SSL, we can either disable or enable it. If we actually look at what's available on the display, it's been enabled system wide. So we could, for example, say disable it. Don't worry about that. For the purpose of this demo, it doesn't matter. And similarly with HTTP connector, we could disable, enable, or force. And if we're not sure, let's just stick the help flag on and we can get some explanation of how this command works. You can also set operation mode between development, non-production, production advanced, production standard, assuming you're using a fully fledged IB000 installation and not the developer edition. In which case, you'll see evaluation mode available in the list. And this is the command you can use to change your installation when you've decided from evaluation you want to go to production. And you might choose something like production advanced, for example, which mine is already set at. So you can get help with nodes and servers. You can get help with setting, enabling and disabling and setting other options like the mode that your installation is running as. Another feature that's come along in the last year or so has been the ability to specify different JRE versions. Currently, we have 8 and 17 as supported versions in the product. And if we wanted to, for example, specify which version we want, so I put the double dashes in, I look for version, and we get the completion there. And if I hit tab again, it offers me 17 or 8. So I can't accidentally, I could still accidentally put the wrong number in, but if I rely on the bash completion, it will automatically complete what's valid. I believe, I think I'd also need to like add a work directory. So there we go, example of running the specify JRE command. You can also change the Java version on a couple of commands, I think deploy, and again, you'll be offered the 17 and the 8. And I think the same on package. So finally, the last command I was going to show you that we give assistance with is the IBMint set credential. Also, you can import or extract credentials. If you go for the credential type, you'll see you can then get access to all of the credential types. In order to get that information previously, if you look at the help here, it actually tells you to run this command. And there you get the information about what credentials are available and whether they're dynamic or static, which may still be, you know, of use. You might want to see whether it's static or dynamic. But in terms of building up the command for importing or exporting credentials, you can just hit the tab key and then this cross-referenced output will be presented and you can just start typing. For example, if I did Google, let's just go for chat, for example, there. And then put more flags in the dashes and we see all the other flags that might be available. And at any point, you can always stick in the help to get the help text to understand how it all hangs together. So let's look at a set credentials example. So if I put the double tabs in first, what it actually does is it's actually restricted how many options are there. If I show you the help, there's quite a lot of values here that you could add to build up quite a long, complex command, which also involves this cross-referencing to other commands. And if I show you the output here, this is a really big piece of output where it shows you the additional credential flags associated with the different credential types. So we're going to look at MQ in this example, because it has some variety, and you can see here, MQ can have 3 different auth types, and depending on the auth type you choose, additional flags are valid or invalid. So this is where the real value comes in with this sort of feature, because we do the credentials, and what we do is we actually ask for credential type first, because when we have this information, we can build up the correct command for you. So having put the credential type in, we now request the auth type, and it's essentially parsing the output from the other command and only offering up the auth types available to the MQ credential type. So if I stay with basic for a minute, and then I go on to ask the new flags, we can see that we have a password flag here and a username flag here. If I go back and, for example, make it basic MTLS MQ, and we now do the tab on this, we can see we still have username, but we have passphrase, we have private key ID, and public key, which matches up here. This is our peer name and passwords. So yeah, there's the password and the SSL peer name. So you can see all the additional flags necessary for that auth type have now been added to the set of available suggestions. So we could continue adding more things. If you have flags like the trace flag, which actually takes a path, you can use the tab to build up a path to wherever your trace is, and so on and so on. So that's the end of all I was planning to show today. As we go forward and continue to add more IBMint commands to the product, as well as fleshing out more variations of the IBMint commands, then this piece of work will continue to evolve with it. And hopefully, as we go forward, this feature will continue to add value to people using the IBMint commands, particularly around the typing, the speed, and the complexity, and just getting valid flags in the right places with valid values. Thank you for taking the time, and I hope this proves useful.